guys, welcome to my very first video on YouTube. I'm Ramesh from CodeWar and today I'm gonna show you one of my project written in C++ language. It is Ludo game. So without wasting time, let's have a look at the source code first and then we will run it. Alright guys, well there is some more source code files attached in this project. I'm not going to show you those files because some of those contains a large number of lines of codes and showing those files may make this video so boring. That is why I'm going to run this game and if it is needed to explain something, I will explain you later in this video. Okay, now we are in the main menu of the game. There is 3 modes in the game, 2 player mode, 3 player mode and 4 player mode. If you want to play in 2 player mode, click on it, click next, select your favorite color and click start. Or you can play in 3 player mode also. Choose your favorite color and click start. But to show you all the features available in this game, I'm going with the 4 player mode. So finally the game has started. Now let me introduce you with the game's interface and its features. The leftmost part is totally reserved for the game board. This part indicates whose turn is to throw the dice at this instant. You can find the game tutorial here in the how to play section. The players can use this sound button to enable or disable the sound effect in the game depending upon their choice. If the players don't like the appearance of this game board, they can choose any other theme for it from the theme section. Now there is 4 themes available in it, which I am going to show you one by one. The first one is Classic, which is a standard game board theme. The second one is the Curvy Corners. The name is given due to the curves present everywhere in the game board. Next theme is the circles. This name is also given due to the same reason, the circles present everywhere in the game board. The last theme is modern interface. This is the default theme of this game. Here, the reset has 2 options for the players. The first one is relaunch, which will restart the game and let the player choose between other game mode for the new game session. The second one is reposition, which the players can use for quick start. It will just set all the tokens to their initial position. I will show you the uses of these two later in the gameplay. Now let's come to the About section. In this section, player can get all the information about this game. There is 3 subsections available: description, information, and the third one is developer section. This developer section is all about me. If someone want to contact me, they can get the required details here in the developer section. Well, I want to share something interesting about this game. Whatever you have seen in this game, I have not used any images of .png or .jpg or .gif file format for this kind of graphics. Everything is being generated by coding at the real time, including this picture. Yes, this is not a normal picture. There is another source code file in this game project where all the pixel colors and its respective coordinates for this picture is defined. The reason behind not using any image file format instead of writing codes for this picture is very simple. If I use any image of .png or .jpg or .gif file format, then I will have to include those image file in the folder containing the final executable file. If someone replaces these image files with some other images, then it will affect the game. Another reason is use of these images affect the game performance, as it will be loaded from the hard disk every time when it is called. So to solve this issue, I created another program which takes some informations like height and width of the required image, etc., and then it will load the image in the memory, read all the pixels of the image and its respective coordinates, then create a C++ source code file and write the image data of the required size within a class. It also creates a header file which you can use to link this class in your project and access all the functions of this class. So this is how I created this picture of me. The last thing to introduce is this throw dice button. All the players will use this button to throw the dice. Now it's time to show you the gameplay. So this is it guys. If you liked this video and want to watch my upcoming videos, Please subscribe my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon and also share it to your friends. Thank you for watching.